which popular game traditionally ends with all the players being thrown into a lake of fiery sulphur?
Well, I hope it's show jumping. Nice. I hate show jumping. I'd have one of those after every jump.
Is there any evidence that people are a bit more bonkers when there's a full moon?
No. It's very interesting. There's been a lot of research about it, and there's been a lot of anecdotal evidence that at loony bins you have to lock them up on a full moon, but actually there's absolutely no clear evidence whatsoever that people behave oddly in a moon.
So why do I go out killing?
Nonsense. What I want you to do, you've got ropes there, is just pull them apart.
Done.
So you can take one each.
Can't be done.
Go on, pull them apart.
It can't be done.
Go on. There you go. Try. You can't, can you?
Be done.
You on, literally right? can't. It's quite extraordinary. Oh, strong oh. as Brian is.
Go on, try and pull, Brian. Pull.
All it is. How come your water no. wasn't spilt? That's magical.
Yes, yes, it's an old trick. Me and Brian have been doing this trick for years.
But to conclude, I say and maintain that of all the tosh cool arse wisps, bum fodders, tail napkins, bunghole cleansers, and wipe breeches, there is none in the world comparable to the neck of a goose that is well downed, if you hold her head betwixt your legs. And believe me therein upon mine honour, for you will thereby feel in your knockhole a most wonderful pleasure.
Yes.
Both in regard of the softness of the said down
yes.
and of the temperate heat of the goose, which is easily communicated to the bum gut and the rest of the inwards, insofar as to come even to the regions of the heart and brains.
We need swear words when you've got knock hole.
Yeah.
Can I swear one thing out?
Yep.
Is it alive?
I fear it probably is.
Yes, I believe that adds the frisson.
Well, it has to be alive, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Because then you can warm. Turn it and laugh in its face. Imagine now, because there's Charmin, there's double-layered toilet paper now, isn't there?
There is.
The Americans will probably use two geese's necks, wouldn't they? To get that extra softness.
Mm. People have been saying for years, why are geese so angry? What's wrong with geese? Why are they so furious?
No, well, we know.
If there were one animal that I was never going to put anywhere near my bum, it would be a goose.
There's so many other choices of animals you don't want near your knockhole.
No, that can be fun.
Get a scorpion to do it.
Yeah.
And he can get all those tricky little nibbles. Oh.
And what's another name for the common cormorant? Yes, Rory.
Sea crow.
Oh. Oh, very good, it is. That's the right answer. Any other?
The Latin what? Name is Phalacrocorax.
What are you going to say?
Can I just give the Latin name? The cormorant is the Phalacrocorax carbo. The shag is Phalacrocorax aristotelis. It doesn't have the white face and the...
This is brilliant. Is it? I mean, this is everything
you
I've got written
called
down.
Tosser, much.
Do you remember anything he said?
No, not a word. He said something about calcium. There's a tree with a funny name. I don't know. Koalas invented rice.
The reason the sea crow is the actual word cormorant comes from Corvus marinus, which is the Latin for sea crow.
Old swotty.
The Phalacrocorax graculus would be. It's the crested cormorant, isn't it? It's because graculus is a jackdaw.
No, a jackdaw is Corvus monedula.
Yes, but it's another word. It's the actual Latin name. The actual Latin name for a jackdaw was graculus.
Okay, so let's not fall out over this, Stephen.
No, no, it's what the...
No,
I'm saying real Latin.
No,
no, you might be interested. The Roman people actually called birds things before they were.
So sorry.
That's all right.
That.
Sure.
There's a portal into the underworld here. It's ridiculous.
Did you have an imaginary friend when you were young?
I don't. Not aware of it.
No, your mother would have told you.
They didn't used to come around much.
Right.
Imaginary
friend who doesn't play with
an
you.
An imaginary friend who kept you dead.
Yeah. Yeah, I wanted to be his friend.
That's so sad.
He just wasn't interested.
Although, it must be said, a certain proportion of them are malevolent. Some people have imaginary friends who scare their children, which is a very worrying thought. A nasty imaginary friend.
I hear voices. What's
that, though?
Do you?
But I ignore them and I just carry on killing.
How upset are the Germans about the 1966 World Cup?
Well, very, I would say. Well, they would be, for surely, I would have thought, a proud nation like the Germans.
They were upset at the time, but I said, how upset are they? They barely remember it. They won. But they, in 1974, beat the Dutch, and that, to them, was the one they really, really care about.
But they, surely, the Dutch have never provided a great deal of opposition to them. Generally, in history, they've just walked into Holland whenever they fancied it.
Oh, in that sense.
Any time they want, they just go into Holland, which is just like spin the windmill. I haven't mentioned it yet. I was talking about the great Geschmertz flip in 1762, where they just walked into Holland, but they can just enter. I'll mention the war. You have to. Surely they're denying their true rivalry, which will be with us.
Why
deny? They're in denial.
We may think that, but it's up to them to decide. I mean, you can't force a German to care about whether they beat us or not.
Well, they bloody well should!
What they should really get rid of is that awful noise of trainers on the floors. Have you ever watched it on television? Squeak, squeak, squeak.
Drives me mental.
Yes. That's why I kill.
That's why you kill.
I've swum with dolphins as well, and it is quite an extraordinary experience.
Very good. Terrible when they reject you. That's horrible. And all your family and all your therapists are standing on the beach. It's freezing cold. And there's loads of dolphins just pissing off back to the sea.
And then you look round
and you go, I suppose we just better carry on with the medication then.
No, Sean.
If they rejected you, Sean.
I mean, at least we tried. Can I have a towel?
Where would you put your ladder if you wanted to get into space?
On top of the spaceship, on a rack. Red flag hanging off of it so some other spaceships don't follow you too closely.
You're saying where you put the ladder, but you'd assume, I suppose, the obvious answer is you'd put it on the highest point, like Everest.
Yes, that wouldn't... That
It'd
wouldn't...
be a bit bumpy, wouldn't it? You couldn't get a good foothold on it.
It's sometimes called a space ladder. It's more commonly called a space elevator. It is a genuine idea that has been worked on, and many people believe would have saved the space program an enormous amount of money in various ways, was to build a huge elevator that goes from Earth and is counterweighted at the other end. It'd spin round incredibly fast, but it would be an equivalent of geostationary orbit at the end of it, and you would have elevators on it that would go up and down. But the important point is you would have to do it on the equator, where the Earth goes at its fastest. Because it's the bit, you know, like the end of a record, goes faster than the middle, obviously.
What about a series of trampolines? They have a huge trampoline, and then up higher up is another one about half a mile up, and then another one. So it's like a staircase of trampolines going up into space, and then there's a big bouncy castle at the top. And a bloke charging you a quid, and you've got to take your shoes off. I'd tell you the best way to get into space. I would tell you, I've just realised it, and it's brilliant. It's just brilliant. I'm going to be so rich. Bubble.
Bubble.
A bubble. Get in a bubble. Just float up
Float
there.
Up there.
One day.
I mean, a big bubble. I'm not talking about... Not talking about those bubbles you see in the... That's not a bubble.
Stupid little one.
Call that a bubble, mate. You're going to see my bubble. No. A big bubble. You get in the bubble, and off you go.
Fabulous.
Yeah. Who wants in?
Me.
This is like the dragon's den for cranky ideas. I had a strange experience when I was in Australia recently, and I went to a day out to the zoo, and they give you a koala to hold, and you have a photograph taken of it. And koalas are very lazy animals. They don't exactly work out. You know what I mean? They haven't got firm buttocks or anything. And I had one in my hand, and it kind of just slipped. And like, before I knew it, I actually had a sort of koala's buttocks. It was actually slipped onto my finger. It was a
just sort of slid on, and there's... on the photograph, they take a photograph of you, supposed to say, hold the koala, and the koala goes... The worst thing was, they wanted it back, and I said, well, can I hold it for a bit longer? And I was trying to get the finger out, and I said, can I take it away?
The list of charges is beginning to add up, isn't it? What do bananas grow on?
Yes. Well, they're monocotyledons, and they grow up like that, and they grow on banana trees, they call them. They're not really trees.
They're not trees. No, take it back, studio. 15 for that. Oh, they are a herb, distinguished by not having a woody stem, essentially, and by dying back after seeding.
They walk.
I'm sorry?
Banana plants, whatever you want to call them, walk.
Nurse, he's out of bed again.
They do. I've been to Colombia. I travelled to Colombia, and I went to a banana plant.
Yes, well, you go to Colombia, you see these things will happen.
I went to a banana plantation, and I said, "Hold on a minute." I said, "Hold on a minute," to the guy. Why? He said, "That big patch to the left of the field." He said, "Because the plants they walk, and they need a lot of room. So you basically need lots of room because plants they move, they walk. Mm. So they have to make the field slightly larger than you. You plant a strip and then you leave a strip because they just move across like that."
I shall have.
You know, like Betty and Keppel in the water.
Sean. As Clive said, the banana plant is actually a herb because the stem does not contain woody tissue. And the banana fruit is technically a berry, in fact, or a juicy ovary containing seeds to you. Now, what sort of... Yes. Stop it. Oh, you're giggling in the back row, miss. The intelligent voice in my ear tells me you're absolutely right, Sean. They do walk. They walk up to 40 centimetres in a lifetime.
Yes!